What's up, everyone? Kornheadfan here. It's been quite a while since I've done a video for the channel, so I'm going to take you on a tour of my new apartment. So let's check it out. Okay, so first off, in the corner we have this pumpkin that got spray painted black, so it's kind of hard to see, but let's see if we can. He's got a face and everything, so meh. Just some decorations. Right down here, this little cabinet holds my PS4, Wii U, and then all my Wii games down here, and then my 3DS and my DS games, along with the system, which is so hard to see in this thing, right here in my Mario case. Got like spare controllers in there. Got movies for my daughter. Let's see. Then you come over here to my first bookshelf. And sorry about the glare. But it's just a lot of horror movies, basically. And I got them arranged alphabetically. And right now I've currently been playing GoldenEye for the Wii, which is really fun. But now I am going to be probably showing these movies off more in depth, but that'll be on a later video, basically doing some collection updates. And down on this shelf is like my drama and some action movies. Like all my Quentin Tarantino movies. This little corner down here is my anime that's not Dragon Ball Z. This is a steelbook version of Akira. So, pretty cool shit. Then you come over here. I got my flat screen with the Wii sensor bar. I've got the SNES Classic. With a bunch of games on it, not the original mount. An NES Classic with a bunch of games on it, not the original mount. Then right down here, I have my PS2 hooked up, got my Wii U, controllers and stuff, the carrying case for the Switch, classic Nintendo or the Super Nintendo. Right behind the TV, because I had nowhere else to put it, is my Wii. Then we come over here to my other bookshelf, and I've got the Lucille bat from The Walking Dead. It's freaking awesome. They have a bloody version too, which I'm going to try and get. I have this lunchbox for Dawn of the Dead that I got at a horror convention, so it's only 15 bucks. So I was like, sure. Right behind that is my Universal Monsters movies collection. Then you have the George Romero Day of the Dead, Dawn of the Dead, Zombie and Dead Alive. I have them on DVD. I have different variants, and like I said, I'll be doing a separate video for stuff like this to show them off more in more detail. Down here is more zombie movies and stuff. You got the whole Walking Dead series that's out right now. Got some Laserdisc I've been collecting now, so every once in a while I'll find one. At the end of The Walking Dead, from the zombie movies and stuff, starts the series. So you got like the Leprechaun movies, got the Omen, Final Destination, Critters, Puppet Master and Full Moon movies. Then you got Trauma movies, and of course the Toxic Avenger right here in the corner. And those are all the movies, plus the Toxic Crusaders movie. I don't have the series for Toxic Crusader yet, but I'm working on it. Then you have the Child's Play collection with the NECA figure, which, like I said, I'll do more in depth later. A lot of sequels and remakes for different movies. Got this cool Killer Tomato thing I got at the horror convention. Let's see. He'll stay in his corner. He's trying to roll away. Then the bottom shelf is, like I said, more sequels and remakes type stuff. movies that are kind of like their own series, like the Saw movies, Reanimator, the I Spit on Your Grave movies. Then you come over here to my lovely Freddy and Jason shrine, which I have a sealed Part 3 NECA Jason mask. Got a poster for the Friday the 13th game, the To Hell and Back Kane Hodder documentary poster, the little reaction Freddy and Jason. Got these Savage World Freddy and Jason figures. This is from the box for this guy, the Part 4 Jason. Right in front of him is the signed copy of Jason Takes Manhattan that I had Kane Hodder sign. A little standee for Jason Lives. Got a cheap see-through hockey mask. I need to find just a plain white one. The Freddy glove. Got Freddy there in the corner, which hopefully when I brighten it you can see him, but just in case I'll bring him out. It's from I believe it's Part 3. Yeah. Right behind him is an artwork poster that I got. The Freddy Spitballs, which I need to find the Jason ones, and those will go right there. Got this cool VHS version of Nightmare on Elm Street. It's got like a little window flap thing. Right below that is the extra parts for the figures. There's a Jason goblet. Got all the Friday the 13th on DVD. Also have the Blu-ray set. It was not cheap. Documentaries on Jason, the Kane Hodder documentary, the Boogeyman compilation. I had nowhere else to put it, so I was like, I'll put it with the Freddy and Jason stuff. All the Freddy DVDs. I don't have them on Blu-ray yet, but I'm gonna work on it. I do have a Part 1 on Blu-ray, mainly for documentaries. Finally got my hands on all the Friday the 13th VHS movies. And I have most of the Nightmare on Elm Streets. I'm missing New Nightmare, and I'm also missing Freddy vs. Jason, so I'm gonna get those eventually. Right next to those, I have the Camp Crystal Lake Memories book, and I also have a laser disc of Freddy's Dead. The bottom shelf is all my NECA Jasons that they've released so far. It's kind of odd that the next one they're doing is the remake Jason, so not sure how I feel about that. But these are, like, this is the NES Freddy. I just got Part 3 Freddy in the mail because they re-released it. So we'll look at those again, like I said, in a later video. I do plan on doing a lot more videos. Right up here is my Halloween Michael Myers section. Got, of course, the Savage World Michael Myers figure. Got the Trick or Treat Studios Halloween 2. I don't know, I thought the skull kind of fit in. And then I've got, a classic butcher knife up there. Got all my VHS tapes. Got the DVDs, documentaries, a bunch of different versions of Part 1. Right below that is the Clive Barker Tortured Souls figures. I'm pretty sure all of series 1 and most of series 2, but I need to look into getting the rest of them. My favorite one's right back there in the corner, which I don't know if you can see him, but it's the one that hangs by his face and stuff. It's pretty crazy. Right below that is my Hellraiser shelf, which I have this weird, another one of those open door VHS ones. Then you've got my VHS copies. I've got the DVDs, and I also have the Crimson box. That was or the Scarlet box. My bad. Whoa. Down here, got my Evil Dead collection, Laserdisc Evil Dead, the trilogy on VHS, multiple copies of Evil Dead 1, multiple copies of Evil Dead 2. Well, actually, there's only one right now, but technically there's two. But we'll get to that. Lots of copies of Army of Darkness. Love that movie. The remake, which, eh. Ash vs. Evil Dead, the series. The Ash vs. Evil Dead figure. The Necronomicon books from Part 1 and 2. And the Army of Darkness Ash, the evil Ash figure. Right below that is my Texas Chainsaw set. Got the original movie on Laserdisc, got the original 3 on VHS, got multiple copies of Part 1, and then basically all the sequels. Also have the figures that they released, that NECA has released, the Ultimate ones anyways. Then we come up here to my awesome Alien shelf. There's a lot to see, so not everything's going to show up on camera. And, of course, I'm definitely going to be doing a review of all these. So there's a ton in the back, like, that you can't even see, but Queens, Facehuggers, the Snake Aliens. Then on the next shelf, you've got boxed figures for Covenant. Got a Facehugger and a Chestburster. We've got the Queen Alien in the box. Got these cool mini busts that are technically supposed to be Banks, but they just look awesome. Some old collectible cards that I found in a DVD. Got some sealed NECA and the 90s Aliens figures back there. Right below that, I have the original trilogy on VHS. I've got the special edition DVDs of 1 through 4. Got the box set of 1 through 4. Got the quadrilogy, which I need a new copy because it's missing the Resurrection disc. The Blu-ray set of all 6 movies, AVP, AVP 2, which sucks, Predator 1 and 2, special editions, got the 3-pack, got a Neomorph figure box, the new Predator from the new movie, and the NECA Aliens figure, with the, I'll just show you real quick, it's like different colored, I think it's to mimic the arcade game, so it's like bright neon red, and it's pretty cool. Thought it was just kind of unique. Right below that, it's my superhero shelf. Got my NECA Batman. Got the classic Adam West Batman. Got the first 3 Batman movies on VHS. Or is it 4? No, I think it's 3. It's 3 of them. Got the Batman collection right there. The Christopher Nolan trilogy on DVD and Blu-ray, Guardians of the Galaxy 1 and 2, Hellboy 1 and 2, Kick-Ass 1 and 2, Man of Steel, Punisher, Spawn, all 6 Spider-Man movies, because love them all, Watchmen, and then all 6 X-Men movies. This is a set of 1 and 2. Then I just got some random movies that I couldn't figure out where to put. Mostly drama, some musicals, some action and sci-fi mixed in there, so it goes down to this shelf too. Like, got Gremlins, Jurassic Park, Sin City, Starship Troopers. I've just recently started trying to collect the Terminator movies on DVD. I found this really cool, it's like a steelbook version, so it's really cool. Trying to get more Arnold movies too, so I got Total Recall. And then, back here I've got, where is it? Go Commando. And then I've got, what was the other one? I can't remember. But it's in here. Oh, and I've also got his very first movie, Hercules in New York, which is ridiculous. Let's see, right across from that, we've got my bookshelf, which sitting on top is my Spawn figures. Classic Todd McFarlane stuff. There's the movie editions of Bulgia, I can't pronounce the stupid name, Violator. Got a ventriloquist dummy that's pretty freaking creepy. Right underneath him, it's the original series of Goosebumps books, the numbered ones, not the re-released ones. Then I've got the Give Yourself Goosebumps and Series 2000. Also got just a VHS copy of The Haunted Mask. Right below that, I've got some comics. I've got Calvin and Hobbes comics. I've got classic Batman comics. I've got, looks like Django Unchained, Pokemon artwork. I've got creepy photos of kids from, like, the past. Got a bunch of binders with mini posters for horror movies. See the Zombie Survival Guide, Toxic Avenger novel, Pulp Fiction book, you know, Kurt Angle's novel. Then you come up, and on the couch, of course, have to have the Step Brothers blanket, because it's amazing. I think I was sitting on it or something, but it's pretty good quality. It's just kind of funny to have. Right above the couch is my wall of figures and movie posters. Got an old Hercules figure, Dark Knight Scarecrow figure, lots of Spawn figures because they're cheap and they're freaking awesome looking. Like, so I've been getting really into collecting Spawn figures. Mainly just, you know, creatures and versions of Spawn himself. Down here we have posters for 1031 and The Barn. The Barn was really goofy and cheesy. 1031 was like an anthology film, so it's pretty cool. Got those from the horror convention, by the way, because I bought both of them on DVD, and they hooked me up with some posters. Movie Spawn figure of Burnt Spawn, and then Classic Violator. I paid like $2 or $3 for that, because the packaging was bent. Got these art posters that a friend of mine gave me. Really freaking cool. I love them. Got this poster for this classic movie called Freakmaker. I haven't watched it yet, but hopefully it's good. Got this giant Creature from a Black Lagoon mask. Just decided to keep it in its packaging. A poster for The Hills Have Eyes. A poster for Zombie 2. Got a Pinhead poster. Texas Chainsaw 2 mini poster. Signed picture of Tom Savini working on Jason Voorhees. Right above him you have Flyboy and Bub from the Romero movies. Got an Evil Dead poster. Attack of the Killer Tomatoes, of course. Right in the corner you got my creepy Joker mask that I made. Then you come over here and, hold on, let me move this cord. It's like tripping me up. You've got, it's just a ton of Dragon Ball Z action figures that are in a bag because I have nowhere to put them for right now. Got original single issues of Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. Like, I don't have all of them, but I'd love to because it was amazing finding all these for like a dollar. Episode guides, strategy manuals for games. There's more strategy guides back here. Got a sealed booster pack from the classic cards. Got two sets of Dragon Balls and miniature ones, and then the bigger hand-sized ones. These little cool statue figures. I've also got a Scouter up here, and I think it's a Korean version of GT, which is really weird. Then I've got all the Dragon Ball mangas and the original Ocean Dub, I think it is. No, Trimark of Dragon Ball, which is pretty funny. Then I've got the first, I believe it was the first releases from Funimation of Dragon Ball. I really love the way they did the covers and stuff with a lot of the characters. I've almost got that complete, but there's a few that are harder to find, like the King Piccolo saga and stuff like that. Got the Dragon Ball movie collection. Then I've got all the Dragon Ball Z mangas. Took me a while to get all those, but got the classic VHS releases. I was buying these brand new when they came out, so it's pretty good memories to have. I think the Brawly Second Coming was the last movie they released on VHS. Then you have these, I call them the Spanish dubs, even though they're not in Spanish, but I don't know, they just look weird. The World's Strongest on DVD, just a classic artwork. Got this cooler 3-pack, it has a Lord Slug movie in it too, which they're no different than the VHS, the artwork's the same, it just comes in a cool set. Steelbook for Cooler's Revenge and Return of Cooler. I paid $50 for this, and I was like, I'm not throwing that away. Got a Brawly 3 set, And yes, it has Bio Brawly in there. I'm not proud of that. Fusion Reborn, Wrath of the Dragon. Got the three movie packs. Got the two newer movies, Battle of Gods and Resurrection F. A lone GT DVD for the lost episodes. All of Kai. Really was happy when they released the Buu Saga because I never thought they'd get around to it. Got the Dragon Ball Super mangas that are out. Got the Dragon Ball Super. I need to upgrade this to Blu-ray, but part 1 through 5. I want to kind of get them all on Blu-ray, so I need to get part 1 on Blu-ray. This binder is all my old DVDs and games for Dragon Ball Z, like the stuff I actually grew up with, as well as all the VHS. These are the box sets I have. The Namek Saga, the Frieza Saga, and the Trunks Saga. I'm working on getting all the different versions of the VHS tapes, but it's a lot harder. I've got a lot of the Majin Buu arc edited and unedited right there. These are all the uncut ones, basically. And I like the artwork on the side, so I want to get all the different ones so I can have the artwork displayed. But for right now, a lot of them are just kind of crammed in there. So, hoping to get another Dragon Ball Z shelf eventually. So I'm going to pause the camera and then we're going to take you on the tour of the rest of the house. Okay, so we're back. We're in my kitchen right now. Hold on, let me get a sip of this coffee real quick. So yeah, a kitchen. Woo. Not much to see, it's just a kitchen. But I did have to bring a bookshelf into the kitchen because there's no room in the living room. Top shelf is like comedy series, Adult Swim, Chappelle Show, It's Always Sunny, Jackass, Workaholics, Power Rangers, stuff like that. Well, yeah, Workaholics and stuff is down here. Continuation, Tim and Eric, That 70s Show. And then when the Workaholics TV show ends, then I got my Tim Burton movies. It's not complete, but I got them arranged alphabetically, ending with Sweeney Todd. Then I got the Kevin Smith movies, like Clerks, Chasing Amy, Jane Silent Bob. And then from there starts my comedy movies alphabetically, which I have a decent amount of comedies, mainly just stuff I like or stuff that I'm wanting to check out. And they're not all comedies. There's some kids' movies thrown in there. Some movies that I just didn't know where to group, honestly. Like, the real Ghostbusters cartoon. I think it's just a couple episodes anyways, but... So yeah, lots of good, funny movies. Wayne's World, gotta love those. The bottom shelf is actually kind of slacking down there, because there's nothing right there, but I'll get to it eventually. So... Now, let's go down the hallway, and we're going to go to my game room. Right off the bat, we got a Nintendo Power poster with all the issues of Nintendo Power. You open the door, you got this cool Breath of the Wild and Twilight Princess posters. Then you come inside, on the back of the door is a couple of Nintendo and Pokemon posters. Then you've got some Super Nintendo, Game Boy, and more Pokemon stuff. And also I have a certificate for my Nintendo system ownership. Woo. Got some more Pokemon, Super Nintendo. Got this cool giant Legend of Zelda cartridge that you can get at GameStop. It's pretty cool. Nintendo poster. Got some old Sears catalog. Like ads and prices for shit. It's pretty crazy. On this wall back here, I've got some bags from different stores that I visited, like Kokomo Toys and The Exchange, and got a Switch bag, Breath of the Wild backpack. Eventually, there's going to be a bookshelf there with all my Pokemon cards and stuff because I have nowhere else to put them right now. So they're just kind of in here. Then you come up to my gaming shelf and on top of the shelf, you have my Nintendo hats, the Power Pad, my Gold Zelda backpack. Got some various stuffed toys of Mario and Link, Pac-Man cups, a couple of the Yoshi Yarn amiibos. Then you come down here, got a couple comic books for Super Mario Bros. And Game Boy. Behind that is all Nintendo games in cases with manuals. So you got like Legend of Zelda up here with the manual and stuff like that. Then you move down. Then you've got more cases. Then you've got sleeved games. There's a few that, like, I couldn't fit Dragon Warrior in a case, so I had to put the manual and the game in a sleeve for now. Wouldn't mind finding that boxed because I know it's pretty cool. More games down here. They're not arranged or anything. Right now, I didn't have the time to arrange them. Then you come down a shelf, you've got the see-through Game Boy. Really love that design. You got the Super Game Boy. Got a couple of Nintendo-themed wallets. This one's like the system. This is just a bunch of different controllers. And this one is actually looks like a controller. So right now I'm using my Legend of Zelda gold wallet, so that's pretty cool. Got a sealed link cable for the well, extend cable for the NES Classic. Got an extra case whenever I get some more games. I got an NES and an SNES cleaning kit. Like five sealed NES games. Nothing crazy except for Treasure Master. That's kind of funny. Captain N and the Adventures of Super Mario Bros. 3 TV show. Got a little Nintendo bank. Bottom shelf is mainly Sega games. Got this Game Boy carrying case, which has my classic Game Boy. Got a Super Game Genie, Super Nintendo games. Got a Super Famicom. Don't have any games for it yet, but hoping to get some. Then we move. Oh, let me see if I can get up. We move up to the top shelf again, and we have sealed Mario Amiibo, sealed Guardian Amiibo, World of Nintendo Sheik and Bowser Jr. or Baby Bowser, whatever you want to call him. Then you got my Amiibos. Top shelf is like Mario characters and stuff. Got some of these cool World of Nintendo 8-bit figures back there. This weird Amiibo C sales associate sign. More of the Mario ones. You got like the Bowser in the suit. You got the 8-bit Bowser and Peach back there. Have the flagpole steps. Let my friend borrow my other 8-bit Mario, the one with the white gloves. So, gonna be getting that back soon. Got gold and silver Mario up there. Then you come down here. I got the World of Nintendo Ganon. I got this, like, it was for socks, basically, but it's a little Nintendo box, so I thought that was cool. Got various McDonald's toys, Burger King toys, some more Amiibos for the Kirby ones. Lots of World of Nintendo figures. There's a classic Mario from McDonald's. I thought I had a Goomba too. I gotta look for that, unless I lost it. There's the World of Nintendo Bowser figure. I think it's freaking awesome looking. I want them to release all the Koopa kids so I can have Koopa and the Koopalings. Then you got more Amiibos back here. Lots of Zelda. Found Sheik and Toon Link for $10 each. I was really happy about that. The Breath of the Wild ones down here. Missing. Try to remember. I can't remember the names, but I know that's Revali and that's Mipha. So I'm missing Duroc and. I can't remember. Fuck it. But yeah, you get it. Oh, and just noting, like, I found this recently. I'm not really, like, didn't give a crap about getting it, but it was $3. It was sealed, but I was like, I don't need it sealed. Got a lot of Animal Crossing amiibos back there. Mega Man, Pac-Man, Sonic, Rob, Shovel Knight, Ryu. 3DS cases, got some empty boxes for Animal Crossing and Twilight Princess and Yoshi's Woolly World on the 3DS. Then down here, you've got the boxes for the NES Classic and the SNES Classic. Got a sealed NES Classic controller. Got some coasters for Mario. And I think this is my original NES that I grew up playing. Then you go down here, and I've got my Nintendo powers and some strategy guides, like secret codes, got a Pokemon one, Mario Mania, that's a really cool book. And it's got the strategy guide for Super Mario in it. I've got this cool Legend of Zelda Wii GameCube style controller for Smash Brothers. I've got a couple GameCube games. I do not have Luigi's Mansion, but I have the case, so if I ever find just the disc, I can complete it. I've got a lot of manuals, little holiday guides, strategy guides. Strategy guides for Super Nintendo and Nintendo games. Zelda strategy guides. Got a art and artifacts guide for Zelda, and the Ultimate Nintendo NES guide. Right back here in the corner, I've got my pins from my Pokemon cards that I've opened. So quite a bit, but I'd love to get more. I have a Zelda NES cartridge pin and a Halloween 2018 pin. Got my PS4 box with The Last of Us on it. Got my Wii box. My PS2 games. Not a lot right now, but they got my Mortal Kombat bookends on them. I'm in the process of playing the Devil May Cry games. I'm on the second one now. Let's see. So I got my NES, my Super NES, my N64, my PS2, my GameCube, my Sega Genesis, my VCR, which I think I need a new one because that one's kind of crapping out on me. Got my TV. Gotta have a classic TV to play Duck Hunt on. Lots of VHS movies, some duplicate movies, some cassette tapes. Right down here, I've got extra controllers, zappers, basically arcade controllers for Super Nintendo and Nintendo. So if I ever want to play multiplayer and stuff like that, I can. Got a mini fridge in here. I haven't really hooked it up, tested it out yet, but that'll make it more convenient when I want to stay in here and game for a while. Then we got a bathroom. Whoa, it's a bathroom. Gonna do a Walking Dead theme in here eventually, so once I get that done, pretty cool. Then I've got my Mighty Max figures right before you head into the bedroom. So it's just kind of a nice little view of my nostalgia. And found that one at a toy store for like $15, I think it was, so that was pretty cheap. These I ordered online because I had originally gotten this set, and then I ordered these four, and I think only one of them. Yeah, that one's in a foreign language, the other three are in English, so that's pretty cool. Then you got my bedroom. Right off the bat, got a cool Dragon Ball Resurrection F poster. A lot of space behind the door. Got my daughter's bed for now. Gonna get her an actual bed eventually. Some mask and a Halloween decoration I had nowhere to put. My bed. Oh, thank God I have a bed. It's nice. Got a comatose poster. Got a corn poster. Then I've got my corn grunts figures. I finally got Jonathan Davis, so I'm happy about that. There's Fieldy. There's David. Monkey and head. So, pretty nice to have those sealed. Got the Korn DVD. Got every Korn album, even all four versions of issues. I'm really proud of that. Different variations, like the. What were they called? The extended versions. I'm only missing the extended version of the that self-titled album. So got a lot of those solo albums down there, greatest hits. Then you got my strange music and horrorcore and stuff like that. Soundtracks. Just recently picked up the Halloween 2018 soundtrack. It's a good one. Also got the Rick and Morty soundtrack. It's pretty crazy. Lots of hip hop, stuff down there, just random stuff. Lots of rock, metal, some Static X, Deftones, System of a Down, Edema, Linkin Park, The Used. So, lots of cool stuff down there. This is like all my EPs and on smaller CDs like that basically don't go on the shelf because they'll slide out. So, lots of underground artists from stuff like that too. Headphones. Then right next to my bed, I've got my magazine rack with my Whorehounds and Fangorias and Rumorgs. Got a couple of sealed Fangorias and a Nightmare on Elm Street comic. It's pretty weird. So yeah, lots of entertainment. Come over here, got my laptop just for shits and giggles. That's where it's going right now. Got my giant pumpkin, got a boatload of glasses in there for just everyday regular use or if I wanted to use them for characters. Just some random junk in there. Frank the Bunny, I don't know why I hit him, but he's in there. In this thing for right now, it's where the rest of my figures are, like ones that I don't have room for to display. Gigantic Venom figure that I found for like $5. It's pretty cool. I got some loose Todd McFarlane figures, like this badass Mecha Violator, which I can't wait to put on a shelf, but for right now, he's in the shame closet. Then I've got my closet with lots of my clothes, lots of weird character shirts that I use for my videos. Yeah, like these ugly shirts and sweaters. Also got these really cool custom shirts, which I can find them. Oh, I got my Friday the 13th jersey and my Freddy shirt. I love those. Oh, okay. So this is a custom airbrush shirt from the movie Class Reunion Massacre. It's a really dumb VHS movie, but I had to have that artwork. It's pretty cool. Used to scare me as a kid. And then I have the Japanese Halloween poster as a shirt. Like, probably my favorite shirt ever. I've only worn it twice. Because I'm just kind of worried about getting it dirty. And it was very, very, very expensive. Probably the most expensive t-shirt I've bought. Oh, and my tracksuit. My red Adidas tracksuit. Love that thing. Only gotten to wear it once, though. It's kind of getting cold out. Got a Nerf hoop. And then got a lot of my toys and stuff for my daughter. Just got her, like, some new pajamas and stuff last night. So yeah, there you have it. That's a tour of my apartment. Like I said, there's going to be more individual videos for collections and stuff like that. It'll just be when I have the time. So if there's something you want to see more in depth of, comment below. Let me know, like, hey, I want to see more than Jason collectibles, or hey, what kind of NES games you got, stuff like that. And I'll try to make a video for all that stuff. I'm also going to be starting a new YouTube channel. I'm not going to give that away yet until I'm actually ready and got the ideas and stuff going. But it is a work in progress. Like I said, just got to find the time to do all this. And I'll be doing more collection reviews of the stuff I have right now. Like, I definitely really want to do an Aliens collection review, because that's my biggest collection probably right now, besides Jason Voorhees, so really excited about that. So, thanks for watching, guys, and stay tuned for more videos.